Alright guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to talk about Atom. Atom is an incredible text editor for web development and other programming languages. You might have seen in many of my videos that I use Atom for web development. Many people have asked me that I have a few functions that they do not have in the Atom. Why is that? That is because I have installed a few plugins and packages that help me to code better and faster. So in today's video, we will see the top 10 Atom extensions that you can use to make your coding life much, much easier. So when you hear this term such as plugin, package and extension, what comes to your mind? Extension is basically a functionality that we use that we do not have in our software, and we want that, so we add it to our software externally. These extensions are already prepared by developers. So today, we're just going to see how to install them in Atom and start using them to make our coding life much, much easier. So let's go back to Atom. And this is a screen that you'll see as soon as you open up Atom. Now to install these plugins, you can use one of the two ways that I'll show you right now. First one is very simple and it is right there on your screen. You can just see on this welcome guide, you have this option called as install a package. Just click here and you can click on open installer, and here you can see install packages has appeared. You can just type the name of the package you want to install and click on install. Okay. Now the second method is, if you don't have this welcome guide, what you can do is, suppose you have a screen like this, you can just go to file, then go to settings. And then here, go to this last option called as install. And here, you can do the same thing that we were doing earlier. Okay. Now, let's get started with our extensions. So the first extension that we're going to see is called as emit. So we'll just search for it. And after searching, you can see that the result has appeared on the screen. You have to download this emit 2.4.3. And you can easily distinguish because it has the maximum number of downloads, and it is by Mentio or Mentio. I don't know how it's pronounced. And you can see that I've already installed this because I'm using many of these plugins. So if you haven't installed it, you'll see this install option. So just click on this install option and then it'll be installed. Now, before showing you what Emit actually does is, let's open up our HTML file. Let's just close all of this and open HTML file. Okay, now inside this, I just have this basic HTML boilerplate HTML code. And here, now suppose, let's say I want to create a div of class home. What will I have to do? I'll have to write div and then hit tab. Or another way I can do is, I'll just write div and hit enter. You can see automatically class appears up here. I can give it a class of home. The same thing, I want to create an ID. So again, if I click on div and hit enter, you can see class appears, but I don't want class. I want an ID. So I'll have to manually type it out, manually type ID and then give it an ID. Let's say about. Okay. And then this is the way it's done. Let's see another way. Let's enable our emit. Sorry, I did not disable it. So it's already enabled. Let's just disable it and I'll show you one real thing real quick. Okay, so now what happens if I write div dot home and hit tab? You can see nothing at all happens. I'll write div found about and I'll hit tab. Nothing at all happens. Now let's go back, let's enable it. I'll do the same two things. Again, I'll write div dot home and hit tab. This time you can see that without even specifying that we want a class, we have a div with a class of home. Okay, and now what if we want ID? So we can write div found and write say about and hit tab. Now I have an ID. I have a div with an ID of about. Okay, we just use dot and pound because those are the symbols by which we call class and ID. Okay, now what if I don't want to write this div? I'm too lazy. I want to save more of my time. So what I can do is I'll just write dot and home This will automatically create a div with a class of home. And if I write pound and home, it automatically create an id div with an id of home. You can do this for h1 dot heading, and then you can just hit tab, and then class will be created. You can do this for paragraph. And if you want to check out more cool features that you can do using Emmet, you can just go to Emmet, then click on settings, and you can check out all of their key bindings that you can use, make your coding life much easier, and use all of their functions by which you can save you a lot of time, and then just make your coding, improve your coding speed. Now let's move package number two. Package number two is called as file icon. Okay, you can see this atom hyphen file hyphen icons. This is the one we're going to install. Okay, so again click on install. Now again I'm using all of this, so if I have to show you what they do, I have to disable them. So again I'll just disable it, and notice something weird happening on the screen right now. Now focus on the left side of the screen here where you have your project. As soon as I enable it, you can see that now this folder has a different logo. HTML file has a logo of HTML5. CSS file has a logo of CSS3. And if I disable it, again it's gone. Now the same thing if I have a JavaScript file, so I'll write app.js. So it'll give a logo to this JavaScript file. If I have a PHP file, I'll write index.php. So it'll give a logo of PHP. Okay, so this is what basically file icon does. It's more related to how our browser looks and how good we want it to look. It's just for visual representations. Okay, this one. Now let's move on to the third package. It is called as minimap. So we'll just write minimap. You have to click, you can see this atom hyphen minimap. Okay, here's the maximum number of downloads. Okay, so we have to again click on install. Just disable it again. Let's go back to index.html, and you can see now, let's just copy it and I'll paste it a few times just to show you a few things. Now you can see that if I want to navigate through this HTML file, I have to scroll and go to the part where I want to go, or either use my arrow keys. Okay, now let's enable minimap. Now you can see something on the right side of your screen. If you can just click here and you can move to the any part of the code that you want to go to. Okay, suppose I have to make a few changes here in this part of the code, so I can just go directly here and type out whatever change I want to make here. Suppose I want to make change at the start of the website, start of the code, I can go here and make changes here. So it lets you easily navigate and manage your code through this easy mini map, or a map of your code completely shown on the right side of the screen. Okay, it is also available for CSS and JavaScript. Okay, so this was it. Now the next extension that we're going to see or talk about is called as color picker. Okay, you won't find it in the top, but you have to scroll a little bit down, and again you can see, you can notice here that this color picker has maximum number of downloads. Okay, now let's open up our CSS file, and here let's say I want body, and here we'll give a color of let's say this is white color. Now what if I want to select a different color? How can you do that? So you can see that Ctrl Alt and C, you have to use, if you're using Mac you have might have other commands, but for Windows it is Ctrl Alt and C. I'll go here, I'll click on this, and then I'll click on Ctrl Alt and C. Now you can see that this color picker has appeared, and I can select any color that I want by just dragging it, and the color will be changed to that. You can see, again I'll do it, Ctrl Alt and C. Again this color picker has appeared. I can change the palette, I can just select any color I want, and I can click here, and my body will have that color. And if I disable this color picker, and I go back here and I click on this Control Alt and C, you can see now nothing is happening. I'm clicking it, but nothing is happening. Again, if I enable it, so it'll give me a color palette or color pickup from which I can pick any color that I want. Okay, it is also available in hex values, RGBA values. You can see RGBA has appeared up here. Where you can, you know, this is for transparency, and you can just select any color that you want using this color picker. So this is also very helpful when you want to change a color a little bit, but you don't know the color names, you don't know the hex codes. You can just, you know, click on Ctrl Alt and C and use this color palette or color picker. Okay, the next one that we're going to see is called as Beautify. This is also related to your code, and your edit are looking much beautiful. So we're going to use this Atom hyphen Beautify by Glavin 001. Just install it and go back to. We'll just delete all of this. We'll just keep one of it, and we'll just remove all of them. Now I'll just type anything in the random way. I'll not give it anything. I'm not following any sequence. I'll just hit tab and then P again here, and then one more. Let's see, after this one more, I'll just copy this and I'll just paste it, move further, and let's hit Control S. Nothing is happening. Why is that? So let's go to settings here, and you have to select this option called as format on save. So if you're using packages and you have this, go back to Beautify settings, general settings, and we have to select when we want our formatting or our, yeah, you can see Beautify entire file on save. It is already on. So as soon as I click save, it should happen. So let's, why is it not working? So I can just click on Beautify, and you can see as soon as I click on Beautify, my whole code got formatted. All the p tags that I had lying around everywhere, they were just formatted. It should happen on save, but due to some error, maybe it's not happening on my PC. Let's again try Control S. It's not happening. Okay, so if I go to packages and this Atom Beautify and I click on Beautify, you can see now it happens. Okay, so just try it out. Maybe I'm having a few issues, maybe that's why it's not working on my PC. But always, if it's not working on your PC, you should have this option ticked, that entire file on save, Beautify entire file on save, that whenever you save your file, all those things like lying around will be formatted and they'll be placed properly. Okay, let's try again. And I'll save it. Not happening. Just click on packages, Atom, and Beautify. You basically understand what we use Beautify for, right? Just want to format our code so it looks much organized and much arranged than it was earlier. Okay, now let's check out the next one. Let's go to settings and install. And the next package that we're going to talk about is called as Ask Stack. This package is very helpful. Okay, it is created by this Chris911, and what it basically does is, what you can do is you can ask questions on Stack Overflow by using this Ask Stack package. How do you use it? You can just use Control Alt and A. So if I go here and I write Control Alt and A, you can see that I have to write a question. So let's search for HTML forms, and then let's say HTML, and I'll click on Ask. Okay, now it will search for all these questions that are already present on Stack Overflow. Now I just search for a random question, but you have a, if you have a selective question on mind, you can just click write the question here. Again, you can see, if I show you, you can just write your specific, Control Alt and A, you can write your specific question here, how to add background images, and it's in HTML. So I'll ask it, and as soon as I ask, you can see this result has appeared, and if I click on this, you can see now as Stack Overflow site has opened up, and I can see all these results. And if you want to just see the answer, you can just click on show more and you can see the answers and the questions here. Okay, so this is also very helpful if you are a developer, because many of the developers have doubts, so they go to Stack Overflow and they ask their doubts on Stack Overflow. This is also very important. Now let's move on to the next one. The next one is why many people have asked me personally that how can I do it? How can I do it? So this is the one that I use, HTML preview. You can see atom-html-preview. Now use this package. You can go to packages and you can see preview and HTML. You can just click enable preview. Now you can see whatever I write here, you can see as soon as I type it out, you can see it on the right side of the screen. This is very important when you are writing your code and simultaneously you want to see the output of what is happening on the right side, or the instantaneously you can want to see the output of what you're typing. And it is also very important when it comes to debugging. You can easily debug your code and you can see why it's not working and everything. So this is also a very helpful package. It is called, again, it is called as HTML preview, and it's created by Ham SK. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm bad at pronouncing these names, so if it's wrong, I'm sorry. Okay, so now the next package that you're going to see is called as Double Tag. Okay, it's by dsandstorm. Okay, and what this does is you can just go to HTML, and if I want to change this div to h1, I'll just type h1 here, and you can see as soon as I write h1 here, this tag also changed. Now again, if I want a div here, I'll write div, and again you can see this tag also changes name. Instead of div, if I want a para, you can write para, and this also change. Alright, so now we'll see what is pigments. So let's just uninstall it and install it again. So let me just before installing this, let me just give you a quick preview of what pigments does. Now you can see that I have this colors. This color is hash, this is in hex code. And we all know what white color is. We all know basic colors, we know, right? Black and this color. But do we know what this hex code color is? Do we know what it looks like? We don't, right? So that is why we use pigments, so that we can know what this color, what this hex code color looks like. Because we have no idea right now what this color looks like. Let's see if pigments has been installed. Yes, pigments has been installed. Now you can see that this color, we have a preview of how this numbered or this hex code color looks like. And if I change it, let's say EF7, 8. Now, after some time when pigment loads up and when pigment will find this color, you can see now this is the color that it has. Okay. We can remember these names and it also show what this color looks like. This is why use pigments for. Now as our double tag extension is already inside Atom, I'm going to show a bonus example that is created by Atom and it is used worldwide by many developers. So this extension is called as Teletype. You can see it is created by Atom. What this Teletype does, I cannot show you like this, but I'll just explain it to you real quick. You can also see it on the Atom site. If you go here, you can see Teletype for Atom. It says great things happen when developers work together, from teaching and sharing knowledge to building a better software. So Teletype for Atom makes collaborating on code just as easy as it is to code alone right to your editor. So what you can do is you can install this Teletype extension, and if you have a friend whom you want to code together, they can also install this Teletype and you can connect to them and you can code together. If he is good at backend or he is good at something, he can just, you know, work on backend in your project, and you can work on front end in the same time, at the same time, in the same project. You can open index.php and then index.html and you can use it in two windows. You can create two windows in Atom where you can work on the front end and back end on the same side. So how to enable this teletype? So you can just go here and you can see, you can also see in this preview of how you can, you know, use this code and share it with your friends. So you can, you know, developers, friends can connect it. So you have to just click on this, sorry, close it real quick. You have to click on this button that you see of this and then enter your token, or you have to sign in first, I guess. Yeah, first you have to sign in into GitHub, and then after signing in, you can, you know, paste your token after you have started this teletype. You can just share it with your friends, then you can start coding together. Okay, that was it. That was it for the top 10 Atom extensions that are very useful, that help you to code better and faster. Now, if you guys found my video helpful, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button. And if I have made any mistake of any sort, or if you have any suggestion for me, please do mention them in the comment section. That's it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next video.